A young soldier by the name of Napoleon Bonaparte was about to lead France into a bloody war with Europe, and instead of dancing to the Masonic tune, Napoleon declared himself the Emperor of France. Napoleon was forced to abdicate from his throne in 1814 and was exiled to the island of Corsica. However, in 1815, Napoleon arrived in Paris again, raising a new army ready for a fresh war in Europe. The Masons had a big problem on their hands. Britain and her Masonic allies could not afford to maintain a long-term war against Napoleon without risking bankruptcy. Help came from an unlikely source. Nathan Rothschild was the head of a leading banking family, but because of their status as Jews, they were forced to work from the shadows of others. Rothschild seized the opportunity to liberate his people and offered a loan, demanding in return recognition of the Jews as equals to their European counterparts and the right to openly do business. If the Masons refused, the money could always go to Napoleon. The Masons had no choice but to accept, and the loan transaction was completed. In 1815, British, Dutch, and Prussian soldiers landed in Waterloo, Belgium, where they met Napoleon's forces and defeated them. Napoleon was captured this time, never to return. France was finally under Masonic control. Although historians make little mention of the Masonic involvement in the Revolution, the Masons themselves have to reveal their shadowy movements during this important period in history. In 1904, Marquis de Rossambeau, a Freemason, said before a packed audience, "Freemasonry has worked in a hidden but constant manner to prepare the revolution. We are then in complete agreement that Freemasonry was the only author of the revolution, and the applause which I receive from the left, and to which I am little accustomed, proves, gentlemen, that you acknowledge with me that it was Masonry which made the French Revolution."